Okay, so salamat sa Panginoon for this time. Again, this month of December, we are on our series, Christmas Journey. And titingnan natin, supposed to be it is an Advent, no? The Advent, pero yung church natin, inagaw yung team natin sa prayer meeting. Kaya nag-a Christmas Journey tayo. So we will talk about, of course, yung account ng Christmas, in the four Gospels ng New Testament, no, yung Matthew, Luke, Mark, and John, no. So last Wednesday ay tumingin tayo dun sa book ni Luke, no, and we learned about what is the message sa manger, no. So we thank God dahil the manger points to Jesus, no, and meron siyang sinasabi sa atin na very important about who Jesus is and kung ano yung maging ministry niya. And actually, today, ganun din po yung mangyayari ngayon. Kaya I entitled our message for today, the message of the giver and the gift, no, na makikita naman natin sa book ng Matthew. And next Wednesday, we will look at the account of the book of John, no, which we will see, of course, ano naman yung mensahe ng pagkadating dito ni Jesus Christ sa libro ng John. So, today I'd like to request everyone to please get your Bibles and turn it to Matthew chapter 2. And we will be reading from verse 1 and 2 and then we will jump sa verse 9 to 12. No? Because we will concentrate on this giver and the gifts sa account ng Christmas time nung si Jesus ay dumating dito. So may I request everyone to please stand in honor to the reading of God's Word, Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 and 2, and then verses 9 to 12. Okay, kung meron tayo sa screen, pwede niyo pong basahin dyan. I'll be reading from the NASB version. Verse 1, just follow me with your eyes. Now, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." And having heard the king, they went their way, and lo, the star. Verse 9, and having heard the king, they went their way, and lo, the star which they had seen in the east went on before them, until it came and stood over where the child was. And when they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And they came into the house and saw the child with Mary, his mother. And they fell down and worshipped him. And opening their treasures, they presented to him gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. And having been warned by God in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their own country by another way. May the Lord be praised sa pagbasa ng kanyang salita. Manalangin po tayo saglit. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this privilege that we have to look into your word, to have fellowship with you and with one another. Ang dalangin lang po namin, Panginoon, is that you bless our fellowship, even our time together with your word. Our only desire, katulad ng mga songs na inawit namin, Panginoon, is just to worship you and give you praise and thanksgiving for all the things you've done. So we give you all the glory, Panginoon, for this time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. Okay. Now before I lay down yung mga pag-uusapan natin ngayon about this passage, let me just give you ano ba tawag dito? Disclaimer. Disclaimer bago natin pag-aralan ng salita ng Panginoon. According to Acts 17, verse 25, God is not served by human hands as though he needed anything. Okay? So itong pag-usapan natin, ito yung mga disclaimer ko lang. God is not served by human hands as though He needed anything. Number two, nor these gifts na binigay ng mga magi meant to be bribes. Kasi sabi sa Deuteronomy chapter 10, verse 17, God takes no bribe. Okay? So, if God doesn't need anything, no, kasi He's God, and He takes no bribe, then ang question siguro natin, ano kayang ibig sabihin nitong account na to, no? Ano yung gustong i-point out nito kay Jesus? So what does this giver and the gifts represents pagdating as far as Jesus is concerned? Yun yung titingnan natin ngayon. But first, let us look at the giver. Dalawa lang yung titingnan natin dito sa account na to, the giver and the gifts. Of course, maraming pwedeng pag-aralan dyan sa account na yan, but we will just focus on the giver and the gifts. And we will look at what is the message of this giver and gifts sa atin at ano yung pinipoint or nire-represent nito as far as Jesus Christ is concerned. No? So the giver, of course, kilala natin dyan sa account na yan kung sino yung giver, and that is the magi. O sa ibang account, ang tawag sa kanila is the wise men. And we can see in that account, no, na they are known as wise men from the East. And most likely, they came from, maraming Bible scholars nagniniwala that they came from, it's either Babylon or Persia. No, dahil, if you know the story in Daniel chapter 2, no, nung nanaginip si King Nebuchadnezzar, tinawag niya yung kanyang mga magi, no, para i-interpret yung kanyang dream. Pero hindi na-interpret, di ba, ng mga magi na yan. And then, tinawag ni King Nebuchadnezzar, magi. Tinawag ni King Nebuchadnezzar yung si Daniel. Tinawag ni King Nebuchadnezzar si Daniel para i-interpret yung kanyang dream. And si, of course, alam natin sa story, Daniel was able to interpret that dream. And kaya many scholars believe na yung mga magi, yung mga magi, they learned it. No, they learned it from the prophet of God. No? So, kasama din dyan yung prophecy na binigay ni Daniel in Daniel chapter 9, verse 24 to 27, yung sinatawag natin 70-week na prophecy. No? So, yan yung kaya maraming Bible scholars, itong East na to pertaining to the Babylon or Persia. And they traveled about, kung doon sila galing, they traveled about 800 to 900 miles. Kaya napakalayo. At yung daan during that time is not safe. No? Kaya maraming Bible scholars then they believe na hindi tatlo yung dumalo kay Jesus na wise men. Although tradition, or tama, traditionally, may mga pangalan pa yan, eh, no? Si Gaspar. Yan, yung tatlong yan. No? Pero, Bible scholars, maraming Bible scholars, they look at yung, syempre, yung history, no? Yung daan. So, kung magta-travel ka, may dala-dala kang gold, frankincense, and myrrh, eh, nung time na yan, napakamahal pa niyan. No? And kung magta-travel ka na tatlo lang kayo, tas yun yung dala nyo, delikado yun. So, many believe na hindi lang yung tatlo. Marami pang magi during that time nakasama. So, they were also aware of the prophecy in Numbers 24:17, no, na kung saan sinabi doon yung star coming out of Jacob. Kaya kung makababasa nyo doon sa verse na binasa natin, no, magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem. Sabi nila, where is he who has been born of the Jews? For we saw his star in the east. So, what can we learn about this giver, no, or the magi, or the wise men na based on this account, no, we can see, we can learn that this man read and believed God's word. Yan. Hindi lang sila nagbasa, nakinig, no, sa salita ng Panginoon, but they believed. And can you imagine kung paano nila to ipinasa? Diba? From the time of Daniel, Magi's na yon, pinasa nila from the next generations ng Magi hanggang sa dumating si Jesus Christ. They read and believed God's word. Next slide, please. Second, na makita natin dyan sa giver na yan, they sought Jesus Christ. Hindi lang sila nagbasa, naniwala, but they really sought Jesus Christ. 900 miles ang kinalang tinravel, knowing that yung road is not safe, no, but wala sa kanila yon, no, just to see Jesus Christ. They are willing to travel that far para kay Jesus Christ. Question, how far will you go for Jesus Christ? Third na matutunan natin about this giver, they recognize the worth of Christ. No. Kasi makita natin dyan yung mga gifts na binigay ng mga magis, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. So, sabi ko nga kanina, during that time, ay itong mga bagay na to, yung gifts na binigay nila, ay mahal, no, at valuable during that time. So they recognize the worth, and we will talk about that later. No. Pang-apat, they humbled themselves to worship Jesus Christ. Okay? Doon sa story, we saw na nung nakita nila si Jesus Christ, they fell on their knees and worshiped God. And by the way, no, doon sa account ng mga magi na yan, ay nung nakita nila si Jesus Christ, sabi ng account, nasa bahay na sila. Okay? So wala na sa manger si Jesus Christ during that time. Kasi yung sa shepherds, di ba, mapansin nyo, pinuntahan nila si Jesus Christ lying on a manger. Pero ito, makita nyo, in verse 9, they came into the house. Yeah, they came into the house and saw the child with Mary. Kaya nga merong sinasabi rin yung mga historian natin na nung makita si Jesus Christ, 2 years nang nakalipas. Kaya nung pinapatay ni Herod ang mga bata, it's 2 years old below. Yan. Okay? So ganun kalayo, pero they went. They sought Jesus Christ. They recognized the worth of Christ. They humbled themselves to worship Jesus. And lastly, they obeyed God rather than man. They obeyed God rather than man. It's kasi sabi dyan sa last verse ng chapter 2 ng Matthew, and having been warned by God in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their own country by another way. So makita natin dyan that itong mga magi obeyed God rather than man. Kasi ano ba sabi ni Herod? Pag nakita nyo, sabihin nyo sa akin kasi i-worship ko rin siya. Pero alam natin sa account na hindi yun yung desire ng heart ng hari. Pero sabi ng Panginoon sila, ito yung gawin nyo. So they obeyed God rather than men. So they were truly wise men. So if you want to be a wise man, tulad nitong mga magi na to, do not just be hearers, but doers of God's word. Amen? Seek Jesus and His righteousness and all these things. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Ano pang pwede natin matutunan dito? Recognize the worth of Christ. treasure Jesus Christ. Ika nga ni Pastor Ivan. Treasure Jesus Christ. Fourth, humble. Humility in worship. And then obey God rather than man. And those are what we can learn from these people. Well, makita rin natin sa kanila is yung basis ng genuine worship. And the basis of genuine worship is right learning, and then right giving, and then right serving. That's what we can see also sa mga taong yan, sa wise men na yan. No, makita natin yung genuine worship nila. But, sabihin ko po sa inyo, right learning without or depart from knowing the source, no, which sila, kilala nila who Jesus is empty knowledge. So kung alam mo lang pero hindi apart from the source, then it's empty learning. Giving or generously giving apart from a loving relationship with Jesus Christ, then it's empty giving. And service that is sacrificial but done in the power of the flesh is empty service. No? Kaya let's be careful, no? And let's learn from these wise men na nagpakita ng genuine worship sa Panginoon. They learned, and when they learned about Jesus Christ, and when they learned about God's word, they gave and they served. Okay? So punta naman tayo sa gifts. Yan. But before I give yung learning natin sa gift or observations natin sa gifts, generous giving is a reflection of the giver's desire to show how valuable the person is. So yung pagbibigay ay nagre-reflect sa iyong desire kung gaano ka-valuable and wonderful yung taong pagbibigyan mo. Okay? That's one of the points na gusto kong ibigay sa inyo today. Kasi makita natin yan sa mga magi, the wise men. Makita natin yung value nung person na pinagbigyan nila because of their gifts. So ano ba yung mga gifts na binigay nila? And the disclaimer ulit, the Bible doesn't tell us any other significance to these three gifts na binigay nila. Walang sinabi ang Bible. However, tradition has its deeper meaning dyan sa tatlong yan. So, una natin tingnan yung unang gift nila. Ano yun? Gold. Ang liit naman ang font yan. Okay? Gold yung binigay ng mga magi. So, throughout history, gold has been considered the most precious metal. No? Metals and the universal symbol of material of value and wealth. So universal symbol siya. And considered the most precious metals in the world. It is a symbol of nobility and royalty. 1 Kings chapter 10, si Queen Sheba ay binisita niya si King Solomon, at nung binisita niya si King Solomon, ay niregaluhan niya to ng gold. Yeah. So by bringing gold, ay the wise men showed na that they indeed consider Jesus Christ as king. Okay? So Jesus, these wise men consider Jesus as king. Actually, sa Matthew, no, si Jesus Christ nire-represent niya, ang representation ni Matthew kay Jesus Christ is what? Alam niya, di ba? Is king. No? And here we see the King of Kings, the King of the Jews, appropriately presented with golds or gold. So addition, hindi lang actually a symbol of nobility and Christ as the King. It is also a foreshadow of another aspect ng ministry ni Jesus Christ. If you open your Bibles to the 1 Kings chapter 6 verse 20 to 22. Can you help me open yung Bible na yan? Although meron naman ako dito kasi makikita niyo rito no that in 1 Kings chapter 6 verse 20 to 22. 1 Kings 6, 20 to 22. The walls of the most holy place I covered ng gold. Yeah. And in these walls, yung most holy place, no, ay dyan ginaganap yung tinatawag nating yung atonement ng mga kasalanan, no, ng mga Israelites. And kaya ako nasabi na it is a foreshadow sa isa pang aspect ng ministry ni Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is our atonement, no? Meaning Jesus Christ dying as a substitute for sinners. No? In the Old Testament, the most holy place, known as the Holy of Holies, was an inner sanctuary within the temple where the priest would encounter the presence of God and offer a sacrifice of atonement for the sins of the people. Likewise, kay Jesus Christ, the incarnation of Jesus Christ, and sinabi kanina ni Pastor Elijah sa atin, yung isang title ni Jesus Christ, Emmanuel. And the sacrifice of atonement he would make on behalf of his people when he went to the cross. So it's a foreshadow, no, nung ginagawa nila dun sa Holy of Holies sa gagawin ni Jesus Christ. So it is not just a representation of Jesus as King, no, nobility and royalty, but it is a foreshadow as well of what Jesus will do for his people on the cross. Second, na gift na makita natin dyan is the frankincense. Frankincense is an aromatic gum that is still widely used in most parts of Middle East hanggang ngayon. At siya ay nakukuha sa tinatawag na Boswellia tree. So kinakat daw yon, and then may lumalabas na parang anong tawag dyan? Tagta. Hindi ko alam paano yun. And doon kinukuha yung frankincense. And yung dagta na yan, yung gum na yan, na lumabas doon sa Boswellia tree, ay kapag nasunog, ay maano yung amoy, no? Very aromatic. Highly fragrant. Parang ginagamit din siya as air freshener. And it creates a strong and beautiful aroma. It is used in worship, where it was burned as a pleasant offering to God, found in Exodus chapter 30, verse 34. And sabi dito ng verse, Exodus 30, 34, "Then the Lord said to Moses, Take for yourselves spices, onycha, and galbanum spices, and pure frankincense, and there shall be an equal part of each." So, ginagamit din po siya as a pleasant offering sa Panginoon. No, but frankincense represents his deity ng ating Panginoon. Because it is used for worship. At sino lang bang wino-worship? Amen? Walang iba kundi ang ating Panginoon lang. And if frankincense represents Jesus' deity, then it speaks of who God is. That Jesus Christ is God. And kung titingnan niyo yung sinabi doon ni God, no, when it comes sa pagbigay ng offering sa Kanya, pure frankincense. Well, there's a parallel, no, and reflection din kung ano yung gagawin ni Jesus Christ, that Jesus Christ will live a life of pure and pleasing sa Panginoon. So frankincense is a symbol of purity, holiness, and righteousness. At yan po yung gagawin ni Jesus Christ habang siya ay nandito sa earth. He will live a life of purity, holiness, and righteousness. It is because of the sinless life of Jesus Christ that we have hope for eternity in heaven. If Jesus sinned, kung nagkasala si Jesus Christ, there would be no sacrifice for sin. Pero hindi, no? Jesus lived a pure life, a holy life, and righteous life. No? Yan ang symbol ng frankincense. It is a symbol of righteousness and holiness. It represents Jesus' deity. And lastly, myrrh. Ang myrrh naman is nakukuha din siya sa isang tree. And the same manner kung paano kinukuha yung frankincense. It was a spy and was used as an ointment and embalming. Ointment and embalming. John 19 verse 39, and there came also Nicodemus, which at first came to Jesus by night and brought a mixture of myrrh and aloes, about 100 pound weight. So ito si Nicodemus, nung namatay si Jesus Christ, no, at nilibing siya, pumunta siya doon, at meron siyang daladalang myrrh. No. So, it is not just a use for embalming, yung sa mga pag-imbalsa mo do. It is also sometimes mingled with wine. No, kaya kung maalala nyo, in Matthew 27, verse 34, pinainom si Jesus Christ nung wine na may halong myrrh. Ang gall yung tawag doon. It's a bitter-tasting substance made of a plant such as myrrh. Ayan. So yun yung pinainom kay Jesus Christ. At ang ginagawa nun sa katawan is maging manhid. No? Parang anesthesia yung effect niya sa ating katawan. So mapait siya. Kaya nung natikman yun ni Jesus Christ, anong, di ba, tinanggihan niya? So, anong nire-represent naman ng myrrh? No, myrrh represents the gift for a mortal at emphasizing Jesus' humanity. Talk about his suffering and persecutions. And myrrh also represents the manner in which Jesus would save his people. Namely, that he would die for them. Isaiah 53, verse 5. So those are the Magi's gift. Okay? To Jesus. Gold for his royalty. Kingship. Frankincense for his deity. And myrrh for his humanity. And to the fullest extent, death and burial. Hindi ko na nilagay dyan yung Samir. So, as I end, ito yung question ko sa lahat. No? What is your gift to Jesus this Christmas? Remember, if gifts, is a reflection of the giver's desire, kung gaano ka valuable ang taong pagbibigyan mo sa iyong buhay. What is your gift to Jesus Christ? And one of the practical things na masasuggest ko po sa inyo is this. Next slide. Everybody's birthday. Okay? Next Sunday na po yan. This coming Sunday na po yan. And the amount na ibibigay nyo dyan will reflect how valuable Jesus is sa inyo. Okay? So that's what we can learn from the giver and the gifts ngayong gabi. And I hope and I pray we will take it to heart and apply sa ating buhay. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this account na makita namin, Panginoon, yung mga lessons, Panginoon, that we can learn from these wise men and their gifts sa inyo, Panginoon. Nakita namin, Panginoon, yung qualities na meron ng itong mga wise men na to, Panginoon. And we pray, Lord, na maging katulad din po nila kami. They are not just hearers, but doers of your word. That they sought you, no matter how far or difficult the road. They recognize your worth dahil sa mga gifts na binigay nila, Panginoon. And they worship you genuinely because of the gifts na binigay nila sa inyo. And salamat din, Panginoon, for the learnings that we can see from the gifts. It reflects who you are and what you're going to do or what you have done, Panginoon, habang nung kayo ay nabubuhay pa, Panginoon. And salamat, Lord Jesus, dahil sa inyong buhay, dahil sa inyong mga sufferings, dahil sa inyong kamatayan, kami ay nagkaroon ng eternal life. Kaya, Lord, as we remember, Panginoon, yung mga bagay na ginawa nyo sa amin, especially our salvation, and yung pagpapakita nyo kung sino kayo, you are our King, you are our Lord, our Savior. As a token of our gratitude, Panginoon, we will give back to you. Not because you need it. Hindi rin bribe. But it is a reflection of how valuable you are to us. Kaya tanggapin niyo po, Panginoon, ang aming regalo sa inyo this Christmas. And ito po yung kinukomit namin sa inyo. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.